Hey guys, Justin here.
I'm in Mandurah right now, and the first ever premiere on this channel, yes.
Yes, this is going to be the first ever premiere. I'm not going to talk too loud because... Hello
passengers, your next service leaves from platform 1 this service stops all stations to Perth.
The reason I'm not going to talk too loud as compared to Hong Kong because in Australia, every single one next to me understands English. In Hong Kong, sometimes maybe people don't understand English, but in Australia, everyone understands English, so I don't want to talk too loud, okay? So the seats, everyone is looking on the other side, so that's why we're all good.
We're going to take full journey on Mandurah Line.
Mandurah Line passengers, due to scheduled track maintenance, your train services will be replaced by buses tonight between Perth and Auburn Grove. Transperth apologizes for the inconvenience.
We wait for the train to leave. It says 2 more minutes for this train to depart, and this is one of the longest lines in Australia, Perth. So we're gonna go all the way back out to Perth from Mandurah, which is 50 something minutes. And this line will actually connect with the other line as well, which is I think this is just going over to Perth, but it's probably also going to connect to Butler with the Joondalup Line. So probably at the bottom, the description, I'm going to say it's terminating at Butler, but I don't know. But I'm just going to count this one as a full journey because the line has changed names. Because this Mandurah line is only for Mandurah over to Perth. So that's why Perth Underground terminates there. Wait for the train to depart. I don't think anyone would be like me actually standing on this train because there's so many seats.
Just wait for a little while.
We get started. There are only two types of trains, I think, in Perth, which is A trains and B trains, and we're on a B train right now. For most of the time, I'll be taking B trains if I film. I'll be filming very carefully over here because this is not a place I'm familiar with. And also, you guys won't be seeing a lot of door openings and closing because we actually need to manually open our doors if I want to get off, so train doors are closing. This is the last car, so that's why it's going to be not too many people hopefully get on at the back here. Now every single car has its train number, has a number, but I will not be able to memorize and remember the numbers. So at the bottom, you will only see the train car instead of the set. Remember from last time when we took the last video, one of the videos of the day, Wanborough to Mandurah. How long is this section? It's like 10 minutes. Now I'm gonna describe the whole line here. I hope I remember the stations. If not, I need to refer to the map in a way. Which is Mandurah. Let's go and refer to the map over here. Which is Mandurah, Wanborough, Rockingham, Willard, Winana, Auburn Grove, Cockburn Central, Murdoch, Bull Creek, Canning Bridge, Elizabeth Quay, and Perth Underground, which is Perth.
So
So there are a lot of stations, and this is the longest line, Mandurah Line. We terminate at Perth, we get off at Perth. That's the full journey. Later on, I will for sure actually do journeys that actually with line crossings on the same train, because like I said, Joondalup Line connects with the Mandurah Line, and Fremantle Line connects with the Midland Line. But today we'll be only on Mandurah Line. Now for the first journey, it actually says also goes to Butler, because it's also going to Butler for the first journey, Elizabeth Quay to Perth, because it's actually the same section on the Joondalup Line and also the Mandurah Line. But that's the little section that actually both lines interconnect, so that's why we're still set down as Mandurah Line. Today we're just gonna do Mandurah Line. Later on, I'm gonna take from Perth back out to one station random in the middle, and I'll change buses back to my uni. For filming buses, we're gonna take another strategy later on, because they're all single deckers, so that's why. But the thing is, not too many people actually take buses. That's why, because not too many people actually take buses in Australia. They just mostly drive. Australians mostly drive their own cars. So buses, they're all single deckers, and I need to figure out a new strategy to film safely instead of getting caught. I don't know whether it is, just like not to film the people's heads, so I'd probably sit on the side and film like what I do for trains, like next to the windows. not too much to talk about, just enjoying the train journey. But actually, it should be Warnbrow. That's how you actually spell the station name. Warnbrow. W-A-R-N-B-R-O. But you just pronounce it Warnbrow. Doors open on the left for this one. But if you guys want to get off, then you click the door button to open the doors. The door won't open. That was actually pretty troll, the door actually opened. The next station. Now there are only 6 cars for this train, but actually it actually consists of 2 trains because just like a light rail, 3 cars and then it has a train head, and then with the train head actually pulling another train head. So car 3 and car 4 actually are the fronts of the train, basically, the train heads cars. But they just connect both train heads together and form another section to make it long. So just to make it longer that way. So a total of 6 cars for this one. Now that is the only section that's actually very long. For the for these remaining sections, they're okay, like 4 to 5 minutes. Yep, we're gonna do Mandurah Line full journey to Perth. Mandurah to Perth. And it will connect to Joondalup Line from there, but basically it already converts to Joondalup Line halfway at Elizabeth Quay, because Elizabeth Quay to Perth, this long section is actually both lines. But they basically combine it both into one, but I'm just going to do it with one line system. There are Mandurah Line, and for the first video I was still said it's part of Mandurah Line, so... Or I might just gonna... I've not uploaded it yet, but I just might just go ahead and mix it up. It's like... Mandurah / Joondalup Line for that one, you know? Rockingham. So there won't be any platform gates for every single station here, because this is Perth. And of course no one will be getting all the way at the back here.
This is Rockingham.
Honestly, I have no idea why this door actually keeps opening over here. Willard. No buses actually reaches, no trains actually reaches my uni, so that's why I only can basically take buses to reach my uni. Willard. At least actually in Perth, it also say next station, which is okay. Instead of like some other stations, only say the name of the station when it almost arrives at the station. It'll be a long journey to stand all the way to Perth, but that's fine. First day we're doing a full journey, this is awesome. Next time when I film, we're gonna do more full journeys, but we're on the other lines. I really don't get why this door actually just keeps opening. Sorry about that last cut.
This is Banana.
Okay, this time the door didn't open. I really apologize for the cut there because due to cops walking around, so that's why I just stopped the recording real fast. Grove. That little 20-second cut, there's not too many like crazy things happen, so didn't skip any stations, so good. not too much to talk about. Just let you guys to enjoy the new lines here in Perth. Oh, Auburn Grove doors open on the right.
This is Auburn Grove. Next
is Coburn Central. I still don't have faith to actually film in the middle cars yet, just in case there are too many people seeing me film. I'm already doing a very interesting strategy of doing kind of a natural position of standing without like specifically showing that I'm filming, which is actually get my hands crossed on my waist, crossed out on my waist, and then put my phone on my one hand holding it like naturally. It's kind of hard to explain, but yeah, just cross my hands on the waist, just like this, cross my hands on the waist, and I put my phone like right here, put my phone on top of my elbow, which just looks like me crossing my hands without doing anything, just holding my phone on my hands. Then I'm actually filming on my other on my phone. Yeah, there's just a little cut in the middle there. That's no problem. We can resume the journey now. Not too many people actually get on. There's another train over there. All of these stations actually have buses actually connecting. So I'll be getting off at Canning Bridge Station later on after the day. I'll get off there and change bus back over to my uni. Maybe have a quick early dinner, and then I'll buy some stuff at the supermarket, and I'll head back to upload videos for you guys. On the right again. Is it on the right or on the left? Why there's so much stuff, too much junk on here. I guess it's on the right.
This is Coburg Central.
The door actually opened at the front.
Door's
Murdoch. We're almost back out to the closer areas to the city, but we're still not even at the city yet. Murdoch, doors open on the right. So far it's actually a lot of fun. I'm not even joking, so far it's a lot of fun on this route. This is the longest route. Some of the others only cost like, takes like 25 to 30 minutes.
This is Murdoch. Thank you.
Bull Creek is the next station. For these stations, I really actually want to get off at a certain station that I can like actually eat stuff, but the thing is, there are like no restaurants close by to any of these stations, so that's why you can see how rural Perth is. Station is quite short, it's quite close to each other. I believe Bull Creek is also doors open on the right. Hopefully you guys can actually hear me what I'm talking about, because I cannot really talk too loud. Just in case the people around me, because they all understand English, so. Bull Creek. Yep, doors open on the right. Canning Bridge, this is the station that we're gonna get off later on, but first let's do the food journey all the way to Perth. We're almost at the city center. Thing is, you can see already the city all the way back there. All the way over, there's the city. But we're actually just basically traveling right next to the cars, which is also pretty cool. For Canning Bridge, I think it's doors open on the left for Canning Bridge. I was going to find a bus stop for Canning Bridge, because they said there's actually also a bus transfer at Canning Bridge, but I need to find it out later on when I want to take back. right, arrived at Cannington, not Cannington, because it's actually another station called Cannington on another line, but this one's Canning Bridge, not Cannington. Right, there's Cannington. Ah, there's Canning Bridge, gosh dang it.
This is Canning Bridge.
Next is Elizabeth Quay.
Doors
we head straight out to the city. And this key is the city. And of course, we have the most important station, Perth, also in the city. Next station, Elizabeth Quay. Next week I will be starting to have lessons, so that's why filmings will be like around 1 to 2 times per week. Maybe, well, actually 2 to 3 times per week. Totally on both channels, okay? It's not like every week 2 times trains, 2 times buses. No, we're gonna be like maybe 2 to 3 times overall for both channels every week later on. Because I need to go to spots where I can take trains or not. I need to go to spots that I can take the trains instead of just randomly, you know. We're almost at the city. The city is just at the back there. Yep, we have arrived at the city. We're head on the ground from here. Because the stations are inside the city, of course, they cannot really do it overground. There is an overground station for Perth, but they basically do it in a cross method. So that's why one needs to be when one is overground, the other one has to be underground, because they cannot do both overgrounds when they cross into the both directions. You have to do it either in separate levels or at a different spot. And of course, we'll do it in a separate level, so we head underground from here. I believe this train will continue its service on the Joondalup Line. Arrived at the city, you can see there are more things here for sure in the city. Doors will open on the right. Arrived at Elizabeth Quay, where we started the first journey of the day here.
This is Elizabeth Quay.
Wow, the door also doesn't open, huh? Even as a big station like this, this still doesn't open. And next station is Perth. Yep, it will continue its service on the Joondalup Line. But Mandurah Line service ends here at Perth. So we're getting off at Perth. Here is Perth. This is the terminus for Mandurah Line. Mandurah Line, and it will continue its service to Butler on the Joondalup Line. But Joondalup Line is not Mandurah Line, so end here at Perth. Ooh, we arrived at Perth again after a loop. You gotta be kidding me, I still need to press the button even though I'm at Perth. Arrived at Perth, and I will see you guys next time. Thank you so much for watching this little premiere. This is a very fun premiere, so I really hope you guys enjoy this one. This is the first premiere on the channel in Perth, so... So really hope So really hope you guys enjoyed this first ever premiere in Perth, and I really hope you enjoy. Next time we're gonna do some more Outer Line. So till then guys, take it easy, click on these videos up top, remember to subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace!